the whole idea of that song was you don't have to fit into this box to be a country girl.
Palmer, who grew up listening to country legends like Patsy Cline, has for over a decade fought for a seat at the country music table.
Welcome to Color Me Country.
Her Apple Music radio show, Color Me Country, continues that fight by celebrating the accomplishments of people of color in country music. The title comes from an album by Linda Martell, the first black woman to play the Grand Ole Opry. Palmer first played that famous stage in 2007.
My friend, Rissi Palmer is back.
And returned for the first time in 13 years this past Friday night.
I left too soon, it'd take 20 years. A few left turns to get me back to where you were when love was still in Somerville.
Boy, does she sound good. Rissi Palmer joins us now only on CBS This Morning. Rissi, good morning. It's so great to have you here. It's so great that you were back at the Grand Ole Opry. How did it feel to be back?
Well, first of all, thank you so much for having me. I'm super excited to be here. It felt great. I was telling my husband, it felt like a full circle moment. And it felt like kind of a ribbon tying on one part of my story. And the beginning of another part.
You said it felt healing. How so?
I think for a long time, I personalized a lot of what happened because I ended up leaving the record company in 2010, and I've been independent ever since then. And in the very beginning, it always felt like, I don't know, like I was pushed away or like I was rejected. And so I took a lot of that personally, even though that's a lot of what the music business is. Yeah. And having that moment and being able to stand on that stage again after so long and everything that I've been through and everything that I've learned, it was just like, I don't know, it was healing. It made me feel like, okay, you got this. You're doing, just keep pushing for, just keep swimming.
Like that's and your daughter was there. Your 2-year-old daughter was there?
My 2-year-old and my 9-year-old, they were both there. And yeah, that's us in the dressing room. And, they had, I mean, they're, you know, they're road kids.
Yeah.
So they're used to being at shows and things like that. And I don't know that they knew the gravity of it, but they had a good time.
Had your 2-year-old seen you perform before?
She's seen me do small things, but she's never seen me do like big things yet. Cause you know, she was born at the beginning of all this. So my husband said when I came out on stage and she saw me on the screen, she started going, Mama, Mama.
That's always so nice. Rissi, I first heard about you from gospel great B.B. Winans, who sent me your music years ago and said, listen to her. So I've been on the Rissi Palmer train for a very long time. So I'm really thrilled to meet you in person. But, you know, when you, it's really good to see you in person. You said that with the Hall of Fame and the Grand Ole Opry, if you had to do it over, that you're doing it again, and this time you're doing it smarter. What does that mean, doing it smarter?
I think a lot of times when you're a new artist, you come into things and you're just like, if I just keep my head down and I just do this and I just think about myself, like everything will work out. And with every great movement, there's cohesion and there's a group effort. And I wish that I had been thinking more globally as opposed to locally, meaning just myself. Mm-hmm. And so all the years of kind of rebuilding myself and rebuilding my career, I've realized that there's power in helping others and there's power in us coming in as a group. And so I come into my career at this point with the radio show and with the fund that we've started and everything else, like thinking globally. Let's think just Rissi. You know what I mean? Yeah.
I do know what you mean. The country music numbers are not so good, less than 4%. What needs to be done, do you think, right now to make it more inclusive?
I mean, that's a great question. I think that it's a matter of...
Because black people like country music too, Rissi.
Yeah.
Yes, we do.
Black people love country music.
Yes, we do.
It's not even a question. Yes. And not only do we like it, we're also a part of it.
Yes.
And we help make it and to create it. And so I think the biggest thing is not a matter of let me run out and get as many black people as I can and sign them.
Yeah.
It's a matter of supporting the people that are working on music and doing this and making things accessible. So like, you can get demos made, you can sign a publishing deal, and you can learn how to do these co-writes, make management accessible, like just all of it. And that it's not just artists. It's also like I spoke before on the show, it's a matter of who you hire and all that.
Rissi, we got to go, but thank you. Congratulations again on playing the Opry stage again. It's really exciting. Thanks for being with us. We really appreciate it. We'll be right back.